Hi everyone, I am Pratima Nayak. So today we will be solving 10 MCQ question of CBSE 2020 class 12 mathematics question paper. You know that there will be 20 questions of 1 mark. Out of that, 10 questions will be MCQ questions, and I will explain here concept with the solution. First question is, if A is any square matrix of order 3 into 3 and determinant of A is 3, then the value of adjoint A determinant is how much? So here we will apply the formula. The determinant of adjoint A is the same as determinant A to the power n minus 1 when n is the order. So here order is 3. So determinant of A is 3. So 3 to the power 3 minus 1, that is 3 square 9. So C is the answer. Number 2. Suppose P and Q are different matrices of order 3 into N and N into P, then the order of the matrix P and multiplies Q has. Options are 3 into P, P into 3, M into N and 3 into 3. So this is a memory based question. Only you should know that if P has order m into n, Q has order n into P, then P and Q, P multiplies Q has order m into P. So the answer is A, 3 into P. Question number 3. If 2i cap plus 6j cap plus 27k cap into I cap plus pj cap plus qk cap is equal to 0 vector, then the values of P and Q are. So their cross product is 0, so I component is also 0, j component is 0, k component is also 0. So now applying the cross product and equating the coefficient of k, we can write 2 multiplies p minus 6 multiply 1, that is 2p minus 6 is equal to 0. So this gives p is equal to 3. Similarly, equating coefficient of j, we'll get 2 into q minus 27 into 1 is again 0. So 2q minus 27 is 0. Q is equal to 27 by 2. So answer is B. P is 3. Q is 27 by 2. Question number 4 from probability. If A and B are two events such that P of A is equal to 0.2, P of B is equal to 0.4, P of A union B is equal to 0.5, find the value of A condition B. So first we will apply A intersection B is equal to PA plus P of B minus P of A union B. So 0.2 plus 0.4 minus 0.5, that will be 0.1. Now applying formula for A condition B is equal to A intersection B upon PB. So this will be 1 by 4. So answer is 0.25. Fifth question from linear programming. The point which does not lie in the half plane 2x plus 3y minus 12 is less than equal to 0 is options are 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 3 and minus 3, 2. So here the question is which does not satisfy. So you have to find out each and every point here which does not satisfy. You will get C is the answer. Number 6. If sine inverse x plus sine inverse y is equal to 2 pi by 3, find the value of cos inverse x plus cos inverse y. So we know that cos inverse x is equal to pi by 2 minus sine inverse x. So cos inverse x plus cos inverse y is same as pi by 2 minus sine inverse x plus pi by 2 minus sine inverse y. So this will be pi minus sine inverse x plus sine inverse y is 2 pi by 3. So pi minus 2 pi by 3 is pi by 3. So C is the answer. Question number 7. An urn contains 6 balls of which 2 are red and 4 are black. 2 balls are drawn at random. Probability that they are of different colors is 2 by 5, 1 by 15, 8 by
15 and 4 by 15. So here can be first ball red, second ball black, or it can be first ball black or second ball red. So it will be 2 by 6 multiplies 4 by 5 or 4 by 6 multiplies 2 by 5. So answer will be 8 by 15. C is answer.
Now integration question. Integrate dx upon under root 9 minus 25 x square. So this is a direct formula based question, but people do the mistake. Either they leave 1 by 5 or they do 8 3x by 5. So here you will write it. It will be dx by under root 3 square minus 5x whole square. So the answer will be 1 by 5 sine inverse 5x by 3 plus c. So answer is b. Question number 9. What is the distance in unit between two planes 3x plus 5y plus 7z is equal to 3, 9x plus 15y plus 21z is equal to 9. So convert this second equation dividing by 3. It will be same as first. So d1 is equal to d2. So the distance between these two parallel planes will be just 0. So answer is A. Tenth question. The equation of the line in vector form passing through the point minus 1, 3, 5 and parallel to the line x minus 3 upon 2 is equal to y minus 4 upon 3 and z is equal to 2. So it is passing through minus 1, 3, 5. So A vector is equal to minus I plus 3j plus 5k. Simple. Now B vector has a component 2, 3 and here z component will be 0. So R vector is equal to minus I plus 3j plus 5k plus lambda into 2i plus 3j. So B is the answer. Question number 11 to 15, fill in the blanks. Question number 11, if f be the greatest integer function and gx is the modulus function, then find the value of g of f minus 5 upon 4. Now, if we put in fx minus 5 by 4, that will be minus 1.25. And greatest integer function, the result will be minus 2 because minus 1.25 is less than minus 1. And put in minus 2 in modulus function. So the result is 2. Function fx is equal to x square minus 1 upon x minus 1 when x is not equal to 1. And its k when k is equal to 1 is given to be continuous at x is equal to 1. Then the value of k is blank. So limit extends to 1 is x square minus 1 upon x minus 1. This is same as limit x plus 1 extends to 1. So this will be 2. And for continuous function, k must be equal to 2. So 2 is the answer. Next question. Matrix 1, 2, 2, 1 multiplies by another matrix x, y gives the result 5, 4. Then the value of y is blank. So multiplying the matrices, you are getting two results. X plus 2y is equal to 5 and 2x plus y is equal to 4. And solving this, you will get y is equal to 2. Question number 14. If tangent to the curve y square plus 3x minus 7 is 0 at the point h, k is parallel to the line x minus y is equal to 4, then value of k is blank. So now differentiating with respect to x will get 2y dy by dx is equal to minus 3 or minus 3 by 2 y is equal to dy by dx, that is slope of the line, this is same, is equal to 1 So y is equal to minus 3 by 2. So what is y? Y is k here. So k is equal to minus 3 by 2. For question, in question of 14, for the curve y is equal to 5x minus 2x cube, if x increases at the rate of 2 unit per second, then at x is equal to 3, the slope of curve is changing at blank. So this is a tricky question. Dy by dx is equal to 5 minus 6x square. Now, the rate of change of the slope is derivative of dy to dx with respect to t is equal to minus 12x. So dx to dt is equal to minus 12 multiplies 3 multiplies 2. That will be minus 72 unit per second. Question number 15. The magnitude of the projection of 2i cap minus j cap plus k cap on I minus 2j plus 2k cap is, so putting in the formula a dot b by mod b, so answer is 2 into 1 plus 1 into 2 plus 1 into 2 upon 1 square plus 2 square plus 2 square under root. So that will be 6 by 3. So answer is 2 units. Vector of magnitude 5 unit in the direction opposite to 2i cap plus 3j cap minus 6 cap is blank. So here we will get the mod magnitude of this vector. It is 7, and the vector will be 5 times divided by 7 whole into negative of the vector. So it will be 5 by 7 minus 2i cap minus 3j cap plus 6k cap. Question number 16. Check whether L plus M plus N is a factor of this determinant 1, L plus M, M plus N, N plus L, N, L, M and 2, 2, 2 or not, and give reason. So you have to write the answer here. So we'll apply R1 is equal to R1 plus R2. So we'll get L plus M plus N throughout the R1. So we can take L plus M plus N common as well as 2 we can take common. When we can take common something outside, so L plus M plus N is a factor. So here we'll break the functions into two. One is minus 2 to 2 x cube dx plus minus 2 to 2 1 dx. First one is a odd function since it is x cube. So the result is equal to 0. Now one integration is x. So minus 2 to 2 is equal to 2 plus 2. The answer is 4. Number 18. X plus sin x will take as t. So 1 plus cos x dx is equal to dt. So if we'll take 3 outside, then it will become dt upon t. So integration is 3 log t plus c. So is equal to 3 log x plus sin x plus c. Question or in 18. Cos square 2x minus sin square 2x dx. This is formula for cos 4x. So cos 4x integration is, directly we can write, it is sin 4x upon 4 plus c. Here in question number 19, we will take 1 plus x square as t. So 2x dx is equal to dt, or x dx will be half dt. So the whole function will become half e to the power t dt. E to the power t integration is e to the power t. So half e to the power t plus c. This is same as half e to the power 1 plus x square plus c. Number 20. Write the general solution of differential equation dy by dx is equal to e to the power x plus y. First, we must know that e to the power x plus y is nothing but e to the power x into e to the power y. So separating the variable dy upon e to the power y is equal to e to the power x dx. Now integrating both the sides, we'll get e to the power minus y in the left side is equal to e to the power x right side. So e to the power x plus e to the power minus y is equal to constant c. Friends, with your request, I completed 10 questions and other questions solution will be continued. Thank you.